Hey guys, this was a segment taken from our Residents of Evil podcast, so if you enjoyed this and would like to hear the full discussion, you can check it out now on our channel or on iTunes. All right, let's get right into it.
Resident Evil 2.
But then that moves on to the second part of the article, which goes on to explain about Ada. Ooh, the mysterious Ada that everybody wants to see really bad right now. This was from Kusunori Kodoi, I probably mispronounced it, but he was the director of Resident Evil 2. He says, I think wandering around in that dress, getting on with your job as a spy, probably doesn't look as realistic and believable as we want in the new game. So Ada Wong will look significantly different in the Resident Evil 2 remake. That is interesting because the one thing about her is she's a spy in a red dress. She stands out. She's not really going for practicality because she's trying to blend in. Whatever she's wearing, it might still be red. I mean, in the trailer, we kind of see what looks to be a trench coat. And then if you go back to the early concept art for Resident Evil 2, she had a trench coat. So I'm assuming that's what she's wearing. Underneath that trench coat now is a different story. I guess they don't want to go with the dress. Maybe it's something more tactical. Maybe I'm not sure. What do you guys think about this? Do you want to see her change?
Honestly, I don't want to see her change because I don't think it's really that big of a deal. Her outfit wasn't that unpractical back in the day. She probably is wearing her RE2 outfit underneath that trench coat thing.
Okay, so you think it's going to actually be similar? So you think the director
is just lying? I think they're going to keep some of the original or it could be an unlockable outfit. They're trying to keep it suspenseful as possible. And it's kind of obvious what they're doing.
I mean, I think they'll significantly change it in a more practical way, but I think it'll still retain the look of the classic. Maybe she won't have like a mini dress. But in the trailer, it looked like she had a mini dress under the trench coat. What do you think, Tony?
Pretty much the same thing, really. Like, I think that she does have the red dress because it's not like it's not a not practical one. If you want to talk about like not practical battle wear for the field and stuff, that would be her outfit from Resident Evil 4 where she actually wore the red dress and high heels. She was wearing that on all throughout, like, you know, the village, then all the other areas, like the underground areas and the military area and stuff. She was wearing all that.
But it's cool for her because, like, she's, like, looks like just like a normal, well-dressed lady, and then she also can kick your ass in high heels. Like, that's kind of fits with her character, so I wouldn't want to see that, like, change too much. I don't want her to come in with, like, military gear, you know what I mean?
Yeah, like she wore in a Simon Ada.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, you know, like I said, I think it might, maybe it, like, it'll be, like, a bit more like high fashion or something like that, but
yeah,
I don't think they're gonna change too much of it, really. I don't think it's gonna be too much of a big change, even though they're saying that it is. They probably were just more referring to the fact that, like, what she's worn in things like Resident Evil 4. Resident Evil 6 is obviously normal wear too, so.
True, yeah. Actually, in Resident Evil 6, didn't she have an outfit very similar to Claire in the Resident Evil 2 remake?
Yeah, it was very similar.
She had the black leather pants, the red button-down dress shirt, and the black glove.
Not the same, but similar to Claire.
It's got some similarity.
If history is to repeat itself with so far what we've seen on the Resident Evil 2 remake, I'm sure we're going to be happy with what we get from Ada, and I don't think we need to worry. And I also think that if they want to keep it a mystery, we should let it be a mystery.